Hi guys, and welcome to this week's episode of WeebToons. And this is your host, or rather I am your host. My name is Bambi, and of course I am joined with the one Sonile. Yeah, she said her name before I could even have the opportunity. But yeah, I was gonna give you the floor to say your own name, but we can go with that.
Anyways, yes. It's never too late. Hi guys, I'm your other host, Sonile. For today's episode, we'll basically be answering a few questions. Our first question, I'll start by asking you, is basically, okay, this is like for the both of us, but like, what enticed us to create our own podcast?
Oh, what enticed us to create our own podcast? That's kind of tricky, I guess, on my end anyway. And that's simply because, I mean, there's obviously a bunch of podcasts that people can listen to. But then a Zambian anime podcast was like for me, and I believe a bunch of other people. So I figured it would be like so cool to like have something along those lines. And yeah. I figured, you know, I would really want to be a part of it because I talk a lot. I talk a lot. for the people that will probably attend anime, you're definitely gonna see me. I talk a lot, so please stop me when I speak too much. But yes, so I figured, you know, I can channel that energy somewhere else where I can talk to like-minded people, so to say. And at the same time, it's like I get what I want out there because it's what I want to do. Like, it's something I've been wanting to do for a very long time because of what I studied. That kind of like influences it. I didn't want to do like the main thing of my course, like my degree, whatever. But I wanted to do like the audio version of it. So this was like, yes, I very much want to do this because this is amazing. And yeah. I believe it's amazing. So yes. So, but that's just my opinion, my answer. But what about you, Sonile? Why? And what made you like enter podcasting and especially anime podcasting?
I think talking about my areas of interest and having, you know, a platform where I'd be able to speak on anime and have different people relate to things that I say or like different opinions that I would have on certain things is very wholesome for me. I feel like having a podcast, or mainly what made me want to have a podcast, was I just like being in a space where I can talk about things that I like, and anime is one of them. And you know, just like Abigail said, like, she talks a lot. I think even me, I love talking, especially when it's about something that I have a lot of interest in. So yeah, when we basically decided to have a podcast together, I feel like that's mainly what, you know, that was like the flame, you know, and now it just keeps burning. So
like it's burning. Yeah, I was gonna say something like though the words I was gonna use are slightly different. It's like, you know, think of it as a meme where like there's anime and then there's you, and then anime just goes like, I burn for you, and you're like,
yeah. No, it keeps burning, honestly, because it's very exciting to talk about a topic that you love so much. It's just, there's a feeling you get, you know?
No, I really do get that, because it's like, in as much as a lot of people watch anime, there's very few people that you might find watching the same anime that you are, being interested in you are. And finding those people just brings in this sense of, I don't even know,
belonging.
Yeah, like you're happy, like it's a fulfillment kind of thing, and you'd be there like, yes, you know, this is my sole purpose in life. It may not be, but it is, because at that you clicked with the person and it just makes so much sense. Like, there's no other way to say it. Like, I feel like I did this not only for myself, but other people as well that I know would really be interested in anime, because it's in our country, in Zambia rather, that's very not spoken about. You won't really know. You may only know anime people because of maybe shirts that they wear, like anime shirts and that kind of thing, little trinkets that they have with them. But then outside of that, do they really have a platform like for them to speak freely about their interests in anime? That I feel like that's something that we rather I'm assuming both of us are really glad. So, like, because it's anime, like, I really can't even explain it. It's like, it's a feeling, it's more of a feeling than a like than something and like explain, or rather say into, like, talk into words. Because literally I met this girl by the mall where nearby where I'm staying, and then she had like an Inumaki senpai like t-shirt and everything, and I was like, oh my gosh, that's anime. And he goes, yes. And I'm like, you know who it is? I'm like, of course I do, that's my one of my favorite characters, one of my favorite VAs, because like I'm like, after watching anime, especially in sub, you kind of, I got into voice actors and actresses a lot. So people are like, I didn't know, it's that mansplaining like Japanese words to people that you're introducing anime to. That's how I've become. But apparently the people I'm doing that to are not bothered. So I'm really happy. It's like my happy space. Every time I get home, watch some anime with like some of my friends at home, be it like we're watching remotely, like someone else is somewhere else and I'm by my place, it's still really amazing just to like think of, like, to do, because you can talk about something. Oh, did you see that fight? Did you see? Oh, it's so understand. That's amazing.
It's always nice to like talk about things like that with people that, like, you know, also love anime.
And people, and I feel like some people are like, most people rather are starting to get into anime right now because of the various like TikToks that anime influencers are posting these days. So whenever you see something Zambian, something local, you're like, yes, it's also here. There's people that also are into the thing I'm into, and get along with that.
But, you know, now that, you know, we're looking into the memories of, you know, why we started, you know, having this podcast, let's look at a different memory. So what's an anime that made you cry?
No, that's a little too tough for me. No, because let me put it this way. Today, let me not go too far. Today, I watched Boku no Hero season 6 episode 23 and I was shedding tears in the first half because of what happened, and even as I want to talk about it, I can't, because, you know, spoiler and everything. I don't want to do that to someone else. I want someone to go through the journey. So think about it, six
to seasons. Go into the journey and start sobbing.
Okay, in my defense, my tears are like right by my eyelids, so anything get really emotional about, really happy, really sad, I will cry. So I feel like I'm not the best person. So if something is a little too much, too emotional, oh my goodness, wow, okay, but no, I'm trying to think about it, but okay, one of them obviously is One Piece, huge One Piece. I'm a huge One Piece fan. So One Piece,
the biggest One Piece fan that I know.
You see? That you know. for now, you know. And the thing is, I don't even read the manga. I don't want to. I just watch the anime. I was watching the One Piece Red movie came out for downloads like a couple of days ago. So I, did last week or something, I got it, and my friend and I like were watching it actually earlier today, and we're just there like, yeah, just like the hype, and they're just there like so close,
yeah,
because of the music. So I, if something is, you know how anime has very emotional plot. It's very,
yeah.
So a lot of the anime that I watch because of how emotional I am personally, I end up like shedding tears, be it happy tears or sad tears, scared tears or goosebumps.
Even when you're scared.
Sometimes.
Girl.
No. Let no one tell you otherwise. Anime is not always for kids. It's not always for kids. There's different kind of genres. And so you'll be there thinking, oh yes, this is definitely for me, when it's not. But then, I've told you about how like I'm super emotional, so like I've cried in a bunch of anime. I know I have cried, and I cry especially in musical anime because it's like super sad. Musical anime is so intense. I don't know why.
Okay, so, for me, I feel like we're total opposites there, because I haven't I haven't found an anime that would make me cry besides I think the ones that made me cry, it's only two right now. It's like Assassination Classroom and Japan Sinks. That's like the only, you know, those are like the only two that have like made me cry.
You have rights to cry for that one. I you have all the rights to just bore your eyes out.
I can't even remember when I watched it, but I'm not really ready to like relive it. But I know at some point I'm going to have, I want to rewatch it, you know? But right now, there's too pain in my heart.
I recently rewatched it, so of course I was just there like, oh my gosh. Like, I'm really trying to think of like anime that I have seen that just made me feel some type of way. But like I said, I more or less like binge watch a bunch of stuff because I'm, I'll say, trying to catch up. That's the way to put it. So I'm trying to catch up with certain like old anime, new anime, everything in between, whatever interests me. So I just end up crying. Like, I don't want to, I don't intend to, but I'm emotional like that. And I guess maybe that's that. This is why we're paired together. Yeah, like going to be
the opposite.
Yeah, like literally. Yeah, literal polar opposites. But like I said, that's like the best part of it. Cause I don't even know. Okay, no. You don't cry. Okay, wait a minute. There's so much I want to ask you right now. Like so many animes. Like, did you not cry when this happened? You know, but
girl. Okay, it's I don't know why. I don't know. I have watched like different things that people have recommended. One of them was like, is it Grave of Fireflies? I mean, it was sad, but like I didn't fall to my knees in front of the TV screen. I mean, you know.
No. Oh, how could you? Okay, you know what? I won't put that again. Not personally. I have it. But I haven't yet seen it. Like, I haven't seen a bunch of classics and stuff. Like I said, I'm trying to catch up between both the new plus ongoing. That's the thing. So for that one, I have not. But there's that one for that guy with the mask. I don't know the Japanese name. Like, he was like a spirit of sorts. And then humans couldn't touch him. Then if they did, he would disappear. I cried. Right.
Honestly, like, you should like recommend some like series or like anime movies that you think I should watch that would make me cry, and then I will come back with the results. Because guys, I am looking for a bit of character development when it comes to watching things that would make me cry. Like I'm literally trying, because I think most of the things that I watch, it's mainly go anime.
Anime, that's what I'm trying to tell you. Switch the like, moment you switch to like shoujo is very on its own kind of level. Like, how can you not cry? Like, I can't, you know, like, I can't imagine not crying. Like, just I can't. See, I can't even find the words right now.
Anyways, let's not get into the crying of the anime. Let's go to our next question, which is basically your favorite villain from any anime.
Okay. Favorite villain. Okay. My favorite villain does not have one spot. It's a spot occupied by various villains. No. I am being so serious. Like I said, huge One Piece fan. So, of course, people that watch One Piece and are up to date or have passed the Dressrosa arc, you definitely know that Doflamingo is villain and a half. Doflamingo, because that guy, you know, like how there's like Eren and his people are like, oh my gosh, why would you support Eren?
Yeah.
You know, that's Doflamingo, but Doflamingo is there not because he wants to save his friends. He's just like rude. He's just rude. There's no nice way to put it. Like, he had a bad past and he's like, you know what? I am going to like make all of you suffer for what happened to me when I was a kid.
No, I get him.
Yeah. And of course, you know, everyone loves Madara. Like, Madara is like super amazing. Yeah. Yes. And for some weird reason, I would also put like Ainz Ugon from like Overlord.
Because
some people think he's a villain, others think he's a hero. But technically, he's playing both. So I would put him up there. And everything else, I'm blank. I really, like I said, everything else just kind of just leaves your head when you ask a question. Like, oh, what's your favorite villain of anime? Like, everything just leaves your head. But, like, no. But that's just, like, that's me. That's me, personally. But what about you, though? Like, your villains. Like, who do you think are, like, your top tier villains? I feel like I'm going to agree with at least one of them, though.
Okay, right now I am trying to like, you know, think of them, but like the one that came to my mind like really quick was, if I am a huge JoJo fan, guys, like that's my man every single version of that reality. My man, guys. But let's like
I'm sorry, I can't. I really cannot not
like honestly. If you were to ask me,
but
if you were to ask me what's an anime that you love and you keep loving for the rest of your life, that's like JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Let me tell you the villain from the same one. So his name is Yoshikage Kira. You know, Yoshikage Kira. So he's like I think he's the main antagonist from like Diamond is Unbreakable. So honestly, I don't even have a reason. I do have a reason, but like, I don't know, I just find him weird and funny, and I love how he introduces himself, you know, because you would really just ask him, oh, what's your name, and he would like tell you every single thing about himself and where he lives, and his, I don't know why, I just find him funny. And then also he has this weird fetish with like hands, so when he, you know, when he finds a woman's hands like very beautiful and stuff, he's going to kill her, I think, and then he's going to get the hand, and then he'll basically use it for everything. There's a meme that always makes me laugh, is how he uses the same hand to like eat, and then there's like sauce on the hand, and then he sucks it off. I don't know, that's very creepy, but you know, like, that's why we love him.
This is why we like gory things. No, because, you know, JoJo's, like, I mean, no offense to JoJo fans, and I feel like I feel like I'm always attacked by JoJo fans.
Well, we're listening right now. Every JoJo fan, unite.
No. Okay, JoJo, maybe it's just a me thing, but when I'm watching things, I'm into, like, graphics and stuff, so... Yeah. Personally, JoJo's does not reach the standards of what I want. No, see what I said?
Girl!
Already,
what?
No. I know people. And then there's something someone told me that every person is like the next generation. I'm like, then what's the point of? I don't get it. So like, no, it's okay. I don't get it. It's fine. But it's like,
no. Okay. All I can say.
No, I will watch it maybe eventually, hopefully, maybe. It's JoJo's, like, there's just, I mean, I know there's so many memes and everything, we've seen so much about JoJo's, but then at the same time, I'm like, do I really want to watch this with this weird animation going on, you know, like, the extra, I don't know.
Weird animation?
Yes.
JoJo has honestly... the best art style that I
no,
like the best, but like it's among the best art styles that I really like. It has a lot of things that I like.
Let's not even go far. You said that you like, so it's a personal opinion. And the
ain't nobody give a damn.
No, see what I said? I feel like
you just attacked me and every
JoJo
generation of JoJo.
This is
so
like I wasn't expecting JoJo to be one of your favorite like villain people. Like I really can't even explain it. Like, okay, maybe I will watch it eventually. Like,
yeah,
watch it.
And but also, besides Yoshikage Kira, my other favorite villain from the same is Dio. I mean, that's what? Kind of like self-explanatory.
That makes it's organic, if I can call it that way. No. it's such a JoJo fan response thing. So it's,
as in, okay, just give it a chance. Just start from the first one. I think the first one is Phantom Blood.
See what I'm saying.
If you want me to be there, I could be there and like watch it with you. I could be like in the back cheering you on and like showing you like this is why you need to like it. And then when you're like, no, I don't like it, we would like have a PowerPoint presentation.
Wow.
Listing down all the reasons.
No, like this is what I'm saying. Low key, JoJo fans are like One Piece fans, because I would rewatch One Piece with someone. I really actually did, in fact. I've done with a bunch of people that I've introduced One Piece to. I have rewatched One Piece with them just so I can rewatch it myself and hear like the, oh my goodness, wow. That's the same thing.
I feel like the same way you
1,050 episodes currently, but like you just have to love it. Like you can't,
I feel like the same way you feel about JoJo is kind of like the same way that I would feel about One Piece. I don't, you know, dislike it or like hate it in any way, but there's just, maybe it's like, it's always been in my head that I really want to watch it because I did start it, but like I had paused 10 episodes in for reasons that, you know, anyways, let's go to the next question.
Oh, let me not even lie. One Piece was like my Bleach at some point, because it took quite a year to like watch everything of Bleach. So One Piece took a while because the animation style was something I wasn't used to.
Yeah,
everything about it was just like strange, you know. It was like quite old and I didn't see anything that old. Naruto came later, so you know, it was just a bit strange. But then once you get into the story of One Piece, it's like this amazing story. It's like one of those things, like, no, those, in fact, I have so many videos and stuff about like how, like, I'm not gonna watch One Piece. Then once you get onto One Piece, oh my gosh, I need to watch more of this. Most people that actually have actually put onto One Piece have turned to the manga because the animation is behind. That's how serious they went into the One Piece story. So, One Piece is great. Like, I will be a Jehovah's Witness for One Piece. For JoJo's. So we can end that. We can put it on that. We can just end it there. Like, JoJo's.
Before we start going to war. Yes, because of the other ones.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, of course.
Yes. So, moving on. Now let's talk about anime that you may have dropped. So, what's an anime that you dropped a few episodes in?
Anime I dropped a few episodes in. Okay. That's a bit scary because I feel like. No, because I'll be a bit like attacked for some of it.
By me?
I'll be attacked because, like, you put it this way. It's not like I didn't want to finish the anime I had. Because I have this rule, which is the gas to see through, my boy. Kind of like mentality. So when I start something, I need to finish it at some point. I just have to finish it. So what happens? So in as much as it has been quote unquote dropped currently, I'll probably finish it at some point. So it's not like I didn't like this anime. But
why are you hesitating?
No, I'm not hesitating. No, I'm not. Like, because I wanted to give an example of like how One Piece, I kind of started it, then restarted it. So, like, I dropped it first, got back onto it. I started Guilty Crown, dropped it, but then went back to it. That's the thing. I keep going back to things I've dropped overall. So if you ask me, like, have you dropped any anime? It's a very tricky question because I know I will go back to it to finish it because I can't stay with the fact of I haven't finished it. Like, that will not sit well with me.
I get that.
Yeah, so, but then that's me. What about you, though? Have you started and stopped any kind of anime?
Okay, I also have this thing where, despite, you know, people saying or, like, different people telling me that, oh, this isn't something that you would want to continue, I always have that thing where I just want to see how it ends, even if, you know, 90% of, like, everybody says they don't like it. So I think something that I can't say dropped, but, like, something I have, like, it's just on pause right now, is Record of Ragnarok.
Oh, really? Okay,
like, listen.
Okay, one, because like I was trying to check it out and everything, so I saw it
won't really be like, I won't really spoil it for you, because I also don't know what happens, you know, because I kind of dropped it. But like, from what I know, the plot is, or like, you know, the whole story is basically how, maybe I'm wrong, but like what I remember is basically like, you know, these different gods, Zeus and whatnot, all of these different people, I mean gods, they want to like wipe out the human race. So one of the same gods, I should think so, says, you know what, guys, like, no, we can't be doing this, you know, let the people live.
Girl, that was like, I feel like it's okay. I like Ragnarok because it's like a whole mesh of Greek, Norse, and like no more like mythology, because you are right, like the person that came and said no, there's like this whole thing was because like I said I recently watched episode one, so like my memory is very sharp there, so it's she was a half god, she's a demigod, let me just put it out, she's a demigod, she's Valkyrie, and in my mind that's like, oh, that's like a Marvel, like, you know, Valkyrie, because she's like a fighter person,
yeah,
and like that. And then, you know, those, I know, like, my friends, I have friends that really loved Record of Ragnarok, and they would show me fight scenes of like Jack the Ripper, and I don't know who he fought, I can't even remember because like I didn't really know much about it. Them fight, is it Adam and Adam and Zeus? That fight, I don't even know who fought. Like the fight scenes are quite like intense and like cool. I won't lie. So
For me, I think I had watched it last year. I really love the story behind it. You get like, I like how they're like, no, we'll find like the strongest humans and like we're going to fight you guys and stuff, and then if the humans win, or oh, you won't have to kill them and whatnot. I like that. I really like that. I feel like for me, the part where I was like, okay, so I guess we're just getting straight to the point, was when I didn't really see, you know, the whole thing of the same demigod going down to earth and like trying to pick out the strongest people. I don't know why that feels so important to me, because I feel like I should be involved in the story. Like, I want to know why you picked John from down the street. Like, why didn't you pick me?
Yeah.
Like, no. You know?
Okay, no. But should we really go down into what can you do kind of thing? No, okay. I do get that. I really do. I don't even lie, because like it's very like Record of Ragnarok is quite good. Though some people recently, in fact, who have been talking about it, I think there's a new season of sorts. I'm not so sure. But people have been talking about how it's apparently, and I quote, mid. And I'm just here like,
okay, but people think everything is mid, to be honest. So you can't trust somebody else's opinion besides your own.
Yeah, so I liked, like, I watched episode, like I said, I only watched, like, episode one very recently, because I was, that's how I usually watch some of my anime, just get an episode one, or sometimes 1 to 5, to see if I like it. So, Record of Ragnarok, I don't even lie, it's something I am planning on watching, because this, like you said, the storyline is quite amazing. Like, humans were fighting for our rights. Yeah, alive, high key, not even low key, because I don't even know was, but it was very amazing. But anyway,
yeah.
So that's for you. So, Record of Ragnarok. Apart from that, oh, you talked about villages. I know this is like a bit, but you made me think of like Kira from Death Note.
I was going to say that
because you mentioned some Kira person from, was it JoJo's?
So yeah, like,
a minute. I know Akira too. So yeah, like Kira, he must be like one, like a really good villain, not gonna lie. Like,
honestly, there's like, I think there was a time when I was the one place where you should never go for like different opinions on something you love with all your heart is Reddit, because people just, they will drag you down. Something that you love so much could be hated by somebody else, and that's why you shouldn't put, like, you know, somebody's opinion over your own. I know this is like turning into like some sort of mentorship, but like, listen, because I read something that was like, if I were like Kira from Death Note, I'd write my own name, and like, what are people going through?
About it, like, what can you do really if someone has decided today I will write my name at 12 o'clock? I'm gonna get a heart attack because everything else would make sense. Who am I to say? I don't see Ryuk, I can't see him till maybe after you die and I get your death note. Till you get unalived and then I can get your death note. Yeah, so you know, like I like, he was like, in as much as people consider him to be a villain, I don't think I would consider him to be a villain. I didn't even like the ending of Death Note. I feel like he deserved a better ending, same as L, you know, his brother Nier. Like, it, like, I feel like it deserved a better, maybe animation wise. I've only watched the animation, haven't read like any of the manga. So, animation-wise, Death Note for me made sense. No, it did not, rather. It did not make sense.
Why are you changing your opinion?
And alive that way. He should not have left the world that way. He should have... Like, I was assuming Kira would win, but no, he did not. Imagine my shock. Okay, that's a spoiler. So, spoiler alert before what I said, but yes. Like,
you know, I just love how we went from like the anime that we went from like the our favorite villains and then to the anime that we dropped and then back to the villains.
Villains who always suck the anime. Okay. It doesn't matter at all. At all. We will always go back to villains. Because we live in a world where we're always heroes, heroes, heroes. But in the world we're living now, villains are portrayed sometimes as heroes or like, let me give it in Naruto terms, Shadow Hokage, like a Sasuke, you know, kind of thing. You know, he couldn't be Hokage. Okay. No, that's me and Sasuke hate. But anyway, he could not be Hokage. But he became Shadow Hokage. You know, I won't hate, but like, you know, yes. So it's like, there's a lot of things that like, even like, Overlord, Momonga, you know, people like assuming he's evil. He just wants to go home. He just wants to go home back to his planet. That's it. It's not even that serious. But then everyone expects it to be that serious. And certain times is how villains are born. Same way of how they meet them in their childhood. But Naruto did not become a villain, so you know, we have places to learn. But yeah. At the end of the day,
me, to be honest. Because me?
If it was me, no. I would the spite I would have.
Honestly. That's why he's really just better than me. But, you know, let's not spend, you know, a lot of time on how we're, like, a lot worse as compared to Naruto.
Yeah, no, he's better than all of us, actually. Oh, what he does.
So, yeah, what's an anime that you could watch over and over?
Oh, that's easy. Okay, no, that's not. One anime I should rewatch. Okay, for starters, One Piece, it has the episodes I need to be able to power through anything. And it has the movies, too. But apart from that, anime that I have rewatched, Clash of the Elites, because I'm rewatching.
Oh, I love that one.
Exactly. You know, it like you learn something new every time. Then, of course, Overlord, because I've really mentioned Overlord. So I recently, like, for Overlord Season 4, I prepped with a friend of mine and watched it together, and she really, really enjoyed it. And surprisingly, as someone that took over a year to watch Bleach, I would watch Bleach. I would rewatch it because there were certain arcs that I actually enjoyed, which I think were not canon. So I think I would rewatch that. And of course, the one and only Naruto, but canon. I would rewatch that because
I want to rewatch Naruto, to be honest.
And like, there's a bunch of anime that I'm yet to watch that are like oldies, so I can't give my opinion about them yet until I see them. So
yeah,
like over the wait, there's this one anime that I think people don't really know. It's called Ikebukuro Westgate Park. It's a mouthful, yes. But I think it's something I would rewatch because it's amazing. And of course,
what genre is it in?
Huh?
Is it like slice of life? Is it gore?
It's more of a I want to say slice of life. It's like gang life, to be honest, because there's like gangs, you know, fighting together, like fighting against each other. Then there's this guy that's just like a neutral party, so to say. It's okay. Like I said, it's something you just have to like see to like understand. That's how I thought about it. Because certain anime, if someone sends me clips like, oh, check out this clip, this happened in this, I'll be like, if that's interesting to me, I'm gonna get it. And even like, time I got Shinkan as a slime, I literally got it. I had it on my hard drive. And then I re-downloaded everything, including the OVAs and the, like, the side episodes, so to say. So, like there's certain thing I like, it depends, you know, like, but I will rewatch what I have to rewatch. Assassination Classroom, recently rewatched it, the tears, you know. Recently kind of rewatched it because like I was rewatching it like my same friend, like we used to watch Overlord and Assassination Classroom last year, like every week when they come out. We were up to date. I had a timeline. So it depends. But then what would you rewatch if you were given the chance? Like maybe you're only allowed to rewatch a certain number of anime for the rest of your life.
The rest of my life? Okay.
Still standing by that.
Something that I would rewatch, like, I think I'm going to mention too, because they're the ones that are, like, coming to mind right now. But the first one is Ghost Stories, guys.
Oh!
In dub. Like, watching it in like, sub is, it's okay, you know, you wouldn't expect anybody to be like, oh, this is something that I would, like, you know, want to rewatch. But in dub, what was going on with those voice actors? Because that was, like,
it's at hilarious. I have seen a bunch of episodes of it in dub, and
it's honestly so funny. Like, you wouldn't even expect to like hear the same thing in sub. But like, I think the reason as to why I started watching it was because I saw some, you know, some edits on TikTok, and I was like, this can't be real, and it was. And I'm so glad I like watched it. I think I'm going to rewatch it soon. And then the other one is Wonder Egg Priority.
Really? Really? No, is it really good? Because I kept seeing it. But then I was like, should I really watch this? And then, you know, people get posted. You know when sometimes there's a lot of, like, fame towards, like, an anime? Or, like, are people really in this? Or they're just there, like, for the hype? So I put it aside. It's one of, like, my... I might watch it depending on... maybe someone else's opinion that's close to me, but you're the first person to talk to me about it, actually.
Okay, I really like it. I love the story behind it and, you know, the art style and the way everything is. It's something that, you know, would get you emotional, but no, I don't know, maybe to the point where you would cry, but for me, it was just like, oh, but that's not the point. It's really good, to be honest.
I get it. It's tears for me. Same as that. Is it Bocchi the Rock? I need to watch.
You should watch it. Because it's really beautiful. And okay, everybody else out there listening, you should watch it.
Okay. Isn't it like a 12 episode anime? They're about I think first I can definitely like check it out like some, if not even sometime soon. Who am I kidding? I can even down, like, get it, like, by tomorrow.
Like, even right now. Get it right now.
And not, but I will put your words into consideration. No, because, like, it's something I have been meaning to, like, watch or maybe watch. But then no one's really spoken about it so much to me. That's why I'm saying, like, I don't know if I would watch it, but then you just said anime. If you said anime movies, I would have been there. Like, I know certain anime movies I have rewatched probably over 10.
Honestly, when I tell you how many times I have watched Spirited Away, it's very insane.
Then there's me, my small self out there just doing that dance for that white guy with like the red thingy. That's I'm just there like, ooh. Then like he moves his hands. He didn't really move. He's like, I don't know how to explain his dance, but
I think I know who you're talking about.
Literally.
But I guess, you know, that's it for today. These weren't enough questions because we could keep going on and on and on and on.
We really anime. Because, like, that was just serious, isn't it? We said one movie. I was ready to, like, blast you about Howl's Moving Castle and Belle. I love Howl's Moving Castle because it's one of the first animes I ever saw without knowing it was an anime. So I saw it in the dub.
I feel the same about Spirited Away.
It's amazing. Do you understand? I can't. No, okay, but Howl's Moving Castle is, I believe, something that everyone should watch. If you can't watch it in sub, just dab your way through it.
Okay, I know I'm going to get like shorts for this, but like personally, I feel like anime movies, it's not like mandatory, like it's, you can do what you want as a human being, but like most of them should be watched in dub, to be honest.
Really?
Like you could watch like
Spirited Away in sub, and it was so
Spirited Away in sub,
that thing, like No Name, and then I saw it in like sub and I'm like, what is No Name, because I assumed the name would still be No Name in the sub, but it wasn't. But
I think for me, majority of like the movies that I have seen have all been in like dub, you know, like Spirited Away, Princess Mononoke, Totoro as well, Castle in the Sky, all of those. I have basically watched all of them in like dub, because I don't know, it's like, let me just take a break from watching things in sub. Like it makes, I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it just, you know, it just feels right in a way. But like, you know, I'd also watch them in sub, but like dub. But you know, that's not the point of what we're here today.
Because if you're going that way, no, this is not right now. I will save the benefit of the doubt for the dub and sub battle, because it's really, because I have enough evidence on sub that you just be confused. At the same time, dub, because I watched certain things in sub first and I was confused about the dub. So, yes. But yeah, exactly. See my point? So I feel like I think that would maybe be like, it just needs to be like an episode for another day. And also, guys, don't forget to purchase your anime tickets from the Nerd Otaku website. That's nerdotaku.org. You can find the anime tagged. That's what I'm going to put, the tag. So, yes. So you can get your tickets. We're going to have it on the 8th of April. So it's more down kind of thing at the moment. So, you know, get your tickets as soon as possible, because currently they're going at 70 tickets. That's at 125 kwacha. And it's going to be a different price on the same day by the door/gate. So get your tickets there. And please don't forget to follow us on our social media. That's Instagram and Twitter, as well as join the Facebook group for Nerd Cafe. Yeah. Anyway, this has been Bambi and, of course,
Sonile. Bye.
Bye.
My back hurts.